Are backup images more fragile than just copying individual files? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a segment from a question I got some time ago. So my concern is that if you have one huge backup image, which for me could be 2 terabytes or more, or even one logical backup file split into, say, 1 gigabyte chunks, it's relatively easy to corrupt that single file slash backup set. If each file or folder or some subset is backed up individually, corruption is likely to take out a small subset of your backup, not the whole backup. I'm interested to hear your thoughts on this and if you know of any programs that can do something along these lines. Individual file backups can indeed be useful. However, I don't think the solution you're proposing solves the problem you think it does. And to be clear, the concept isn't limited to just backup. It's all sorts of things. Let's have a look. For simplicity's sake, let's describe this problem this way. You have 10 gigabytes of data. You can store it as 10 million files of 1 kilobyte each, or one file of 10 gigabytes. Both represent the exact same data. In one case, it's stored in one massive file. In another, it's stored across a collection of 10 million other files. Which is more resilient to corruption? It depends. Now, I take issue with the comment that it's relatively easy to corrupt a file. These days, it absolutely shouldn't be that easy. If a system is working even moderately well, the chances of a random file corruption are actually very low. Not zero, of course, and this is one reason we back up, but it should be infrequent. If it's happening often, however you want to define that, it's more likely a sign of a problem that needs to be fixed rather than some inevitable circumstance that needs to be planned for. Resiliency, it's relative. A larger file, sure, it represents a larger target. If you're going to have a problem somewhere within those 10 gigabytes, by definition, it will happen inside the single 10 gigabyte file, if that's the way you're restoring the data. Or it'll happen only in one or small number of those 10 million files. What happens next, though, depends on what the data represents and how the software reacts to corruption. If a single error in that 10 gigabyte file invalidates the entire file, then yes, you've lost all the data, and that's a bad thing. It's also bad design. If a single error in one of those 10 million 1 kilobyte files invalidates only that file and no others, that's significantly more resilient. Most of the data survives. But here's the thing. It could just as easily be the other way around. If a single error in that 10 gigabyte file invalidates only a small portion of what it contains, the rest could be recoverable by the software that understands it. You lost little. Most of the data survives. If a single error in any of the 10 million files invalidates the software ability to use the entire collection, then you've lost it all. Again, a bad design. What happens to your data is less dependent on how it's stored than it is on the software that subsequently reads it. Most backup programs try very hard to be smart. If a single large image file becomes corrupted, most backup programs attempt to recover what they can. For example, Macrium Reflect, one of my recommendations, is typically still able to extract individual files from a single .mrimg file, even if corruption in that file prevents a full restore. Most files are unaffected. That's more or less the same result as if you were to restore everything as individual files. Isolated files might not restore, but most files would be unaffected. Backing up individual files, though, isn't enough. A full image backup includes things like partitions, partition information, boot information, file system overhead, and more. That's the stuff you need to ensure you can restore to an empty disk when the time comes. To work as a backup, your collection of individual files needs to include more than just the files on the system. And that's the stuff that, if corrupted, could also prevent you from performing the restore, whether it's stored as a single massive image file or as a collection of individual files. Now, the reason I say that this issue isn't specific to backups is that backup image files are just one example of larger collections of information being bundled into a single file. For example, we regularly distribute software in ZIP or ISO or MSI files or many other so-called archive formats. Each type combines many files into a single, larger file. Depending on the file format and the robustness of the specific tools being used, these files can be just as vulnerable to corruption. In fact, corruption, at least in the wrong place, in these archive files can render them unreadable. And to go even a little bit more meta, when you think about it, isn't your hard disk just a file container as well? You don't have to be using image files or archive files or anything like that for corruption to render your entire hard disk instantly unreadable. Corruption in the wrong place on your hard disk can do exactly that. Hard disks and file systems are designed to be resilient, to tolerate a certain amount of corruption before giving up completely. But there's always a point where things can get bad enough that recovery just isn't possible. This is why we back up. Ultimately, what I believe you're asking for is this. You want a program that, instead of collecting all the information into a single file, like a backup program's image file, copies individual files as individual files and then includes the overhead information as some kind of additional special file that your backup software could recognize and use during a restoration. It's certainly possible, but I'm not aware of a backup program that actually works that way. But it wouldn't help. Either scenario deals with the same data stored differently. If a file is corrupted, it's corrupted, regardless of whether it's inside a larger image file or directly accessible on its own. If the overhead information is corrupted, then the full restore process is impossible, again, regardless of whether it's inside a larger image file or directly accessible as separate special files. I honestly don't believe that this buys you anything. Corruption is corruption, and if it happens in a benign place, you may never notice. If it happens in the wrong place, your entire backup could be invalidated, regardless of how it's stored. What I think you really want are tools like Macrium Reflect or ESUS to do for creating full image backups. They're not perfect, no tool is, but they're good. If there were one thing that I would change, it would be this. I would have them be significantly more resilient to image file corruption. They're good, don't get me wrong, but I would have them try even harder when something is determined to be an error. I would have them offer a best effort restoration in the face of detected corruption rather than just throwing up their digital hands and giving up. Ultimately, the same problems that could keep that from working are the same problems that would prevent the suggested comprehensive file-based backup from working. In both cases, your uncorrupted files are accessible, and in either case, it could be impossible to do a complete restore. Now, I do agree that individual file-based backups can be useful. When your backups are accessible in their original form, retrieving them is simple. You just locate the backup copy of your file and you copy it back. There's no need to file up a backup program to retrieve the file or even look to see what's in the backup. Just navigate with Windows File Explorer and copy the file like you would any other. It could be useful. And that's why I do both. Sort of. I implement a layered approach using an external hard drive, monthly full image backups using Macrium Reflect or something similar, daily incremental backups, again, using Macrium Reflect, near real-time individual file backups using a syncing online service like Dropbox or OneDrive or others. And while I don't do it personally, there's a very strong argument to be made that if your backup program can verify a backup after making it, that might be a good option to turn on, especially if you're particularly concerned about corruption. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/18693. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.